Welcome along to the 29th Winter Universiad in the Krasnoyarsk, Siberia, for day six of the Alpine program. And we have for you today the Parallel Nations team event. A fantastic spectacle for the fans as they can see the athletes skiing from top to bottom of this Parallel Nations track. Here are the conditions. Well, it's slightly cooler than it has been the last couple of days, but it is a glorious day, a dusting of snow overnight, and a very innovative way of getting down the ski slope. That's might catch on. So there is the track, and the racers run at the same time, one racer from each country on each track. And the teams are made up of two ladies and two men's, and they run in the old ABBA version. So skiers one and four will race on the same track. Skiers two and three will also race on the same track. They'll swap over halfway. So one team will race two runs on one track and then the other two runs on the other. So these are the semi-finals for the Parallel Nations team event. Czech Republic against Russia, Sweden against Austria. These four will be battling it out for the medals. Semi-final one of the Parallel Nations team event. It's Russia against the Czech Republic. Sofia Krokina up against Tereza Nova. Russia on the red course, Czech Republic on the blue. And they're away. And it's a good start from Nova. But Krokina has quick times consistently through this competition over Nova, but it's Nova who lands in front. Nova still has the lead. Krokina's going to come quickly, and Nova's out, and Russia will take the first point. Nova on the edge, unable to see it through, and Krokina, 25-38, gives Russia a 1-0 lead. Now, for Russia, Denis Vorobev. For the Czech Republic, Jan Zabistran. And Jan Zabistran has been skiing quickly. 23.38, his quickest time. 24.53, the quickest time for Vorobev. So Zabistran on the red course has the quicker times, and it shows as he comes over the first drop. Zabistran under pressure because he's got to finish, and he's absolutely flying here is Jan Zabistran. Zabistran, two gates from the final drop. Over he goes. Zabistran will level it up. 23.52 for Zabistran. So the last women in this semi-final, Ekaterina Takachenko up against Veronika Chamkova. And Chamkova, quicker times than her opponent in the last round. And Chamkova off to a good start on that far side. Takachenko needs to try and respond. And here she comes. Takachenko super quick over the drop. But Chamkova responds again. And Chamkova just in front. But it's desperately tight here. And Takachenko, I think, is going to land in the lead. Oh, this is close. Takachenko takes it by a hundredth of a second. Oh, that was mighty quick. 25.58 against 25.59. So Paulus has to win, and he has to win 200s quicker than 23.52. 23 and a half seconds will be enough for Paulus. And Paulus, 24 dead in the last round, 23.82 in the first, and the error from Paulus, and Russia will qualify for the final. Alekhine unopposed over the final drop, and Russia take it 3-1. 23.85 the time for Alekhine, and Russia book their place in the big final, the Czech Republic into the small final. Confirmation then. Russia qualify for the gold medal race, 3-1. The Czech Republic will be racing for bronze. Second semi-final pits the number 6 seed Sweden up against the number 2 seed Austria. Austria yet to lose a leg. They've won both their races 4-0. Sweden came through a tiebreak against France in the quarter-final. The combined quickest time, Agnes Dahlin, didn't finish the quarter-final up against Freire. And Dahlin, the second quickest time in the slalom leg of the Alpine combined. Freire, the winner of the gold medal in the Alpine combined. And Freire has the lead, but she's late in the line. But that's a great recovery from Freire. And Freire using all her skills. This is brilliant skiing from Jessica Freire. And Freire takes the win, 24.97. Her quickest time of the day. So now they switch courses. Philip Steinvold on the right of screen on the red course. Richard Leitke of Austria on the blue. Steinvold consistently faster in the first two rounds. Much bigger athlete, but it's a hell of a start from Leitke. And Steinvold is going to have to use those quick times. Different technique from Steinvold to Leitke. But the poor start from Steinvold has given him too much to do. Can he pull it back on the second half of the track? He's getting there, and Leitke still has the lead. Now Steinvold's back on level terms. They're going to land almost at the same time. Steinvold's going to take it. Is he? No, he's not. 1/100th of a second, falling at the line, and Leitke, 23.74, punches the air, goes sub-24 for the first time today, and it gives Austria a 2-0 lead. So Sweden up against it, against the number 2 seed. Louise Janssen up against Denise Dingsleder. Dingsleder has had slower times than Janssen. Sweden could still pull this round, like they did against France. They won the last two races in quick time to win the tiebreak. Austria just need one win, though, to go through. So Louise Janssen on the red course, Denise Dingsleder on the blue. Austria lead 2-0. Janssen has the quicker times from the first two rounds. Can she deliver another quick time here? The start needs to be good. And it is good. Janssen gets the better of the starts and gets the early lead. Janssen needs to win to keep Sweden in it. If Dingsleder can get the better of Janssen, then Austria will progress to the gold medal race. Janssen perhaps just getting a little rounder than Dingsleder, but she's got the lead. Janssen, as Dingsleder starts to come at Janssen. Janssen lands just in front. Dingsleder come. Janssen takes it. By 1900s, 25-26. By no means her quickest. Now Sweden another need a really quick run here from Jakob Persson. Julian Kienreich on the right of screen on the red course. Jakob Persson on the blue course. Persson has to win, and has to win in a super quick time, and Persson is away. Persson has the lead over Kienreich. Good jump from Persson, driving through this pattern of gates. He still has the lead. Persson needs to win big. Here comes Kienreich. Persson has it, 23.84, but Austria get the better combined time to qualify for the final. It finishes 2-2, but it's not enough for Sweden to knock Austria out. There we go, 49.01 against 48.71. The quickest time. So Austria win by 0.3. And Sweden will take on the Czech Republic for bronze. And then Russia, Austria for the gold medal. So the bronze medal race between the Czech Republic and Sweden about to get underway. Sweden and the blue corps, the number six seeds, the Czech Republic, the number eight seeds, and Agnes Dahlin is up against Tereza Nova. And Dahlin, good opening ski from her. Dahlin going nicely, 25.83, her best time. Nova looking to try and pull her back. Dahlin lands in the lead, but Nova's coming good, but Dahlin gets there in the end, just 25.93. Sweden lead 1-0. Philip Steinwall and Jan Zabistrand. Now these are two big athletes that have been skiing really, really quickly in this competition. This is going to be a fascinating clash. Who's going to take this one? Sweden on the blue course, Czech Republic on the red. So Zabistrand up against Steinwall. And here we go, Steinwall on the right, Zabistrand on the left. And they both go to work, bashing the panels out the way. Steinwall just, whoa, it's so close to call. Steinwall with the error, Zabistrand now has the advantage, you feel. Zabistrand in front by a whisker because of the error from Steinwall. Zabistrand lands in the lead and Zabistrand will take it. 23.54 to level it up. Now it is the turn of Louise Janssen and Veronika Chamkova. Janssen has been skiing really nicely. Can she continue on the left of screen? Chamkova to the right. One all in this bronze medal race, and Janssen has the lead just. Chamkova, though, coming back at Janssen, and it's desperately tight here, but Janssen seems to be in front. Janssen will land in front, and Janssen will make it 2-1 to Sweden. 25-25 for Janssen. Tiebreaker. If the Czech Republic win, it'll go to the fastest combined time. If Pearson wins, Sweden take the bronze. Pearson on the red course, on the right of screen. Paulus on the blue course. Paulus has a best time of 24 dead. And Pearson, a best time of 23.75. So Paulus is going to have to dig deep here. And a good start from both racers. And it is Paulus who has the early lead, is it, on this near side? Just has the advantage. Lands in front. Paulus has to ski quickly, has to ski cleanly. And here comes Pearson on the far side. And Pearson perhaps now just shading it. Lands first by a fraction, and Pearson will win it, and Sweden take the bronze in the Parallel Nations team event, and it is heartbreak for the Czech Republic. Yes! For the number six seeds defeat the number eight seeds in the bronze medal match, 3-1, Sweden take the bronze. So now the gold medal race between the hosts, Russia, and the Alpine powerhouse that is Austria. First up, Jessica Freire looking for her third gold medal of these games, up against Sofia Krokina. And Freire has been skiing beautifully, but can she ski beautifully in the final under pressure? It's neck and neck, and Freire perhaps just has the advantage on Krokina, but here comes Krokina. But Freire pulls away again. Freire has the advantage on the far side, on the red course. Russia on the blue course, need to respond. Freire lands in front and Freire will make it 1-0 Austria. Freire 25.08. And the Krokina, 25-42. Great skiing from Freda. Now the men take over as they swap courses. Richard Leitgeb up against Denis Vorobov. Leitgeb going under 24 seconds in the semi-final. Vorobov just the other side of the 24-second mark. Oh, what a start from Leitgeb. He absolutely flew out the start, and he has the early advantage by half a gate on the Russian Vorobov. Brilliant start from Leitgeb. He saved his best till last. Can he just see it through? Coming to the final drop, Leitgeb has absolutely blown Vorobov away. Excellent skiing. What a time that is. 23-48, Leitgeb. Oh, that is a brilliant, brilliant ski.
Austria!
Check this start out. He's at the first gate before Vorobov's even really moved. Brilliant start. So now Denise Dingsleder up against Ekaterina Takachenko. Takachenko the gold in the giant slalom. Dingsleder the silver in the giant slalom. Can Takachenko keep Russia's hope of gold alive in this parallel nations team event? And this time, well, it's Dingsleder who gets the better start. But here comes Takachenko. Takachenko, now she's just behind. Dingsleder lands slightly in front, and now she goes to work. A little error from Dingsleder. Can Takachenko take advantage of it? No, she can't. Dingsleder leads. Takachenko's got to do something here, otherwise it's all over. Dingsleder leads, lands in the air, and she will win it for Austria. Austria take the gold. 25-22, the winning time in that third leg of the final, and Austria win their third gold medal of the Alpine program. And Dingsleder led from start to finish. Takachenko couldn't respond, and Dingsleder, well, came second to Takachenko in the individual giant slalom, but she turns the tables in the third leg, the decisive leg of the Parallel Nations team event, to give Austria the gold.
So cool.
And that just sums it up. So cool. So, Julian Kjaerbeek knows that his team have won gold. He's a gold medalist. He takes on Nikita Alekhine. And Alekhine gets the better of the starts. Kjaerbeek will now try and haul him back in, but Alekhine with those hands out in front, barging his way through these gates. Good skiing from Alekhine, but it's too little, too late from the Russian Federation's point of view. And Alekhine will give Russia a point, but it's not enough. 23-63, his winning time. But it is gold for Austria and silver for the Russian Federation. Austria, the winners of the Parallel Nations team event. Nikita Alekhine with an excellent final leg, but the damage had already been done in the first three races of the gold medal race. And it's all smiles for Austria. They needed to come through a tiebreak against Sweden in the semi-finals. They did that and take the final 3-1 over Russia. Sweden the bronze medalist. But here is the confirmation of the gold medal race. Austria take it 3-1. They won the first three legs. Nikita Alekhine giving the Russian Federation a consolation point in the fourth and final leg. But it is Austria who take the gold 3-1.
In the Congo, Mr. Snackster.
We are glad to greet you at the flower ceremony for alpine skiing parallel nations team event.
And Sweden win their second medal of this alpine program. They won bronze in the ladies super G on day one of the alpine program. And here on day six of the alpine program, they win their second medal, another bronze, this time in the parallel nations team event. Agnes Dahlin, Felix Steinvall, Louise Janssen, and Jakob Persson.
Representing Russian Federation.
And the silver medalists, the Russian Federation, their sixth medal of this alpine program. Two golds, two bronze, and now two silvers. And representing them, Sofia Kokina, Denis Vodobev, Ekaterina Takachenko, who adds her second medal after winning gold in the giant slalom, and Nikita Alekhine, who picked up the bronze in the alpine combined.
First place, representing Austria!
And Austria take the gold medal, their fourth medal of these alpine races here. It's Krasnoyarsk 2019, the 29th Winter Universiad. Jessica Freire picks up her third gold after individual gold in the Super G and Alpine combined. Richard Leitgeb, Denise Dingsleder, who adds gold to her silver in the individual GS, and Julian Kjeinleit, who wins his first gold. Austria are the champions of the Parallel Nations team event. Austria, the number two seed, beating Russia, the number four seed in the final, with Sweden, the number six seed, getting the better of the Czech Republic, the number eight seed, in the bronze medal. Well, that wraps up the Parallel Nations team event. Just two more medals remaining in the alpine program, the men and women's slalom medals. They are coming up, but the Parallel Nations team event has been a brilliant affair on day six of the Alpine program. Thank you very much for your company.